The sick man of the Arabian Peninsula, the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, continues to suffer from its shortfall policies and the lack of any significant support from its Israeli and U.S. friends in the war against Yemen. On February 11th, the Houthis announced that they had launched a ballistic missile at King Khalid airbase in the southern part of the kingdom. Brigadier General Yahya Sadi said that the ballistic missile landed inside the airbase, which is located near the city of Khamis Mushait in southern Asir. According to the spokesman of the Houthi-led forces, they employed a new ballistic missile which was not deployed before. The strike was described as a retaliatory move for the aggression and siege imposed on Yemen. From its side, the Saudi-led coalition claimed that its air defense forces had intercepted the Houthis' ballistic missile. According to the coalition, the Houthis launched the ballistic missile from the northern Yemeni province of Sada to target civilians and civilian objects in Khamis Mushait. A day earlier, the Houthis launched 4 suicide drones at Abha International Airport in Azir. Coalition air defense forces intercepted 2 of them while 2 others hit the airport. The Houthis said that they had used 2 Samad 3 and 2 Kasef 2K suicide drones, which were aimed at military aircraft deployed at the airport. In turn, the Saudi-led coalition called this attack an act of terror and said that a civilian airliner was damaged. Saudi media accounts shared photos showing a damaged Airbus A320-214 plane, a fly-a-deal, a local Saudi carrier at Abha International Airport after the attack. In the ongoing exchange of strikes between the kingdom and the Houthis, Saudi sources prefer to ignore the fact of daily airstrikes on civilian targets in Yemen, highlight the lack of any progress in peace talks to settle the conflict. Furthermore, with every month, the chances of Saudi Arabia to take an upper hand in the conflict decrease as its proxies lose more and more ground on the ground.